Hello, I'm Dale Petrock. Earlier this evening, I went out to the pistol range and fired my S-22 Smith & Wesson Victory handgun in .22 caliber. It is one I've had for about a year now, and I really have enjoyed this particular pistol. It has been modified with a Tandemkross Spitfire barrel and break. It has a Tandemkross trigger and a Tandemkross hammer. It has Volquartsen grips. It's got a scope rail mounted on it, and the scope is a UTG pistol scope 2-7, and it works really well. Lately, I've been trying different ammo testing with it and have discovered that Center-X will shoot from a bench using that pistol setup. Groups under an inch at 50 yards, and so tonight I thought I would take it out and see what I could do. It was fairly windy. The pistol had, some trouble with a pin coming loose in the hammer, and I'd fixed that. And so the other part of it was to make sure everything worked well. So I took it out, and because of the wind, thought that perhaps I would just stick with shooting some TAC 22 to see if everything worked well. And after shooting some of that, it dawned on me that it was shooting pretty good and that I probably could get some reasonably respectable results. So I shot the particular Center-X at some targets and in general stayed under 1 inch at 50 yards off a bench. Now the trick is it's really hard to see the hits at 50 yards even with a 7-power scope. At least with my old eyes, and so you'll see that some of that comes into play with me trying to figure out how to see things if you watch the shooting portion of the video. And I'll have the targets posted in the corner as we go along. Additionally then, after seeing how well it was shooting, I got a little cocky and thought maybe this was a good time to try out shooting that pistol off a bench at an ARA factory class target. And while it did pretty well for what I perceived to be a pistol, the ability to see the shots came into play and I got lost in one towards the end of the target and had to watch the video back to figure out what shots were placed where. And towards the end, my concentration was dying. You'll see that my shots end up going a little wilder than what they should have. But the interesting thing is it has given me pause to consider shooting that ARA target again on a better day under better conditions when I am more alert. It particularly fell apart once a bug flew in my eye, and you know how that goes. Anyway, the shooting portion will follow. The targets should be posted as we went along here, and so if there's any questions, as always, feel free to drop me a note. Thank you.